Hello class. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the EC fundamental. In that also, we will more focus on generation of alternating voltages and currents. In general also, we know an electric current, whether it may AC or DC, is now commonly produced by means of an electric machine known as a generator. A generator which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The mechanical energy is provided by steam turbine, an internal combustion engine, water turbine, or any other prime mover which drive the generator. Okay? Alternating voltages may be generated by a rotating coil in a magnetic field. As shown in the figure, this one, a coil which in between a magnetic field of a magnet and which being connected toward this external circuit via these brushes, slip rings and all. Or in a figure B, we show that by rotating a magnetic field within a stationary coil. Okay, before we going to discuss much more detail about the AC quantities and their definitions and how they can produce a maximum quantity of AC currents and voltages among them. Okay, so here it is a principle of generator. The operation of all electric generators, whether it is DC or AC, is based upon the fact that when a conductor is moved in a magnetic field or a magnetic field moved with respect to the conductor, according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, an electromotive force is set up in the conductor. Thus, as long as there is a relative motion between the conductor and a magnetic field, a voltage will always be generated in the conductor. The AC generators are commonly called alternators. So, here it is. The principle of working is that there are two cases which directly gives us a clear idea that either our conductor should move within a stationary magnetic field or else magnetic field should move with respect to a stationary conductor, and the relative motion between conductor and a magnetic field actually causes the AC voltages. ओके अगर हम इसे हिंदी में सिंप्लीफाई करना चाहें तो फॉर जनरेशन ऑफ वोल्टेजेस एंड करंट एज पर एज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द ए सी द नेसेसिटी कंडीशन द फैक्ट एंड द आइडिया बिहाइंड इज द फैराडेज लॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन वट फैराडे टेलर्स दैट द करस्पॉन्डिंग और को रिलेटिव मोशन बिटवीन द conductor and a magnetic field actually gives us AC current and voltages. How it will be happen? The first, तो फिर पहला situation, पहली case ऐसी है कि हम magnetic field को stationary रखें और conductor को move करें so that the magnetic flux being cut by a conductor, moving conductor, which should collect and gathered us the quantity of इलेक्ट्रिक पावर. ओके और दूसरा केस ऐसा है कि हमें रोटर को मीन्स कंडक्टर को अगर फिक्स रखे तो हमें मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को मूव करना पड़ेगा. सो एज टू द अल्टीमेट रिजल्ट इज दैट कट अ मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स सो इट विल कन्वर्ट दैट मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इंटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी एंड विल कॉल दैट इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी एज एन ए सी वोल्टेजेस एंड करंट which being further connected to the slip rings and resistance to the external circuit. I think it may make sense how AC voltages and current generator. Okay, now the value of generated voltages is depend upon the number of turns in the coil, the strength of the magnetic field and the speed at which coil or magnetic field should rotate with respect to each other. Okay, alternating voltages may be generated in either the two way as shown in figure B and A. But the rotated magnetic field, that is figure B, is the one which is most commonly used in practice. Okay. Now we will discuss about the construction, how it will be constructed, and then we will see the equation. Okay. So here it is. What are the construction points of view? Now, if you consider, if you have seen this figure, then it gives a clear idea that it is an elementary alternator. As I already mentioned before, a second, that AC generator are commonly called as an alternator. It actually consists a single turn of a rectangular turn of a coil, as it is nominated as A, B, C, D, the edges of the coil, which is made up of some conducting material like copper or aluminium. The coil is placed so that it can be rotated about its axis. Yes, it is a dotted line over here. This gives the axis of this rectangular coil at a constant speed in uniform magnetic field provided by north and south pole of the magnet. The coil is known as armature. By the time we will get familiar with this word, that is, the conducting material in the magnetic field is called armature. The end of the armature coil are being connected to the rings, that is, here it is A and B. Okay. It is also called a slip rings, which rotate with the armature. Here it is a two carbon brushes is mounted against the slip rings, that is number 1 and number 2, which also rotate and collect the current which induced in the coil, and it carries to the external circuit via this resistance R. Okay. Now focus about the operation. What actually happened over here so that we get a quantity of current, that is, it is a conversion of mechanical energy, that is, rotation is being converted into the electrical voltages and current. Okay. So by the operation point of view, let's assume that first we have to make an assumption, that is, a particular position of a conductor. So we can get the reference by the that position, the conductor, that armature, the coil is moving in uniform magnetic field, which is being created, which is being maintained throughout the operation by north pole and south pole, and the current and collected by carbon brushes number 1 and number 2, which are mounted on the slip rings along with the axis of a coil, and it being carried to the next circuit or external circuit via resistance R. Okay. Now assume that the armature coil is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So for that purpose, let the conductor edges A, B, C, D, as we have seen earlier, how it will be happen and what are the exact position about it. Consider a rectangular coil having n number of turns, which is rotated in the uniform magnetic field with an angular velocity omega radian per second. Okay, hum aisa assume kar rahe. Then as being time, which is measured on x-axis, and the flux, which actually create a magnetic field, stronger magnetic field. We know that the magnetic flux are the imaginary lines of forces which is generated by a magnet. Okay. And the surrounding area where the stronger magnetic lines of force are experienced are called magnetic field. Okay. So, hum kahenge ki maximum magnetic flux phi m is being linked with a coil. It is being in touch, in contact with the coil. When its plane coincides, means the conductor position and the flux coincides at a time t second, the coil rotated through an angle, that is theta, the angle between the magnetic flux and conductor, is omega t, that is little angle between the, it is moved by a zero position. In this deflected position, the component of flux, as we seen over the vertical lines, that is y axis, okay, is perpendicular to the plane of the coil. Yes, it is, as shown. Phi become phi m cos omega t, hence the flux linkage of the coil at any time can be written as n, number of turns of the coil, kitne turns liye hai coil ke, phi, the magnetic flux, which is equals to number of turns should be constant, phi m get maximum with an angle cos omega t. According to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, the EMF is induced in the coil is given by the rate of change of flux linkage with the coil. Hence, the value of induced EMF, electromotive force, at the instant when omega is equal to the omega t or some another instantaneous value of the induced EMF should be given by a small e, which is equals to my negative sign d by dt, derivative of n d phi. Hold. Okay, we are not going too much in detail about this mathematical expression. We are interested to how much is the EMF induced over here. So it given by mathematically omega n phi m sin omega t, which is tends to omega n phi maximum flux of angle sin theta hold. Okay, so my point of interest is how we can get this EMF, at which particular angular velocity gives us a maximum voltage and a maximum current or maximum current. Okay, so by position of 0, by position of 90 of angle, by 180 angle, by 360 angle, what will happen, we will discuss about that. अगर हम ऐसे बात करते हैं कि कौन से प्लेस पे हमें ज़्यादा वोल्टेजेस की वैल्यू मिलेगी, तो यहाँ पे दिखाई दे रहा है आपको, ये साइन वेव फॉर्म है. और अगर हम ऐसे जूम करते हैं कि एक्स एक्सिस पे हमने टाइम स्लॉट प्लॉट किया है, टाइम एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस को हम अगर कंडक्टर पोजिशन करते हैं, सॉरी वाई एक्सिस को हम अगर मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं, so when there is a initial position in between the conductor and a magnetic field, this will be gives us a whatever, that is the plane of the coil is being perpendicular to the magnetic field, and the conductor of the coil which is moves parallel to the magnetic field. Since there is no flux cutting by a conductor, so there is no EMF which is generated in the conductor, and therefore no voltage flow through the external circuit, which actually this zero position. And if you take the projected axis over a second one, then we will see that it actually, we are talking about the zero position, when the conductor is being perpendicular with respect to a plane of magnetic field. So there is no cutting of a flux, so no EMF will be induced. Okay, now the conductor is moving far away from the zero position, that is it make an angle of 90, that is this B position angle of 90 with respect to the plane of magnetic flux. Then both the conductor of the coil moves at right angle to the magnetic field, it cut a maximum number of lines of force. So the EMF induced in them also maximum. You can directly say that between 0 and 90, the EMF generated in the conductor build up from 0 level to the maximum. Let's say from 0 level to the B, this position, maximum. This is the journey how the conductor rotate within a magnetic field and the flux being cut by a conductor. As much as flux is being cut by the conductor, much more quantity of EMF is induced, and it graphically shown over here. Okay, it happened at 90 of degree where the conductor moves from zeroth position and cut the maximum number of lines of forces. Okay, the current through the circuit, which varies just as the EMF varies, being from 0 to the maximum 90, according to Faraday's laws, from the observer side, the current flow through the external resistors from terminal of the edges. Okay, now we talk about the position number 3 at the angle 180. Okay, now as the conductor and the plane of the magnetic flux attend this angle of 180, what will happen? The lines of force cut by the conductor generally getting reduced. This decreases, hence there is no EMF at this D position, which means this pi radian, okay, at the angle of 180. No flux being cut by a conductor, so there is no EMF produced in this case. Again, as time period passes, the polarity of the conductor being changed. Now the, if we think about the A and B edges at the upper side, now it is goes down, and C and D edges will take the position of A and B, that is upper side occupied by C and D and lower side is occupied by A and B. As time elapses, in negative at the angle of 270, the coil rotates beyond the position, and the direction of the cutting action of the conductor through the magnetic field reverses. Abhi ye reverse ho jayega. Okay. Now the conductor CD cut up through the field of the conductor, which goes through the down, as I talked. Polarity of the generated EMF also being reverse. To make it more clear, a coil position at 270, it been exactly opposite that of zero initial position. Okay. Now, at this point also, maximum number of flux is being cut by a conductor, so we get a maximum quantity of EMF. But make it clear, it is in reverse direction, and it is mathematically shown by negative sign, and graphically it put down below the zero axis, below the x axis. Okay, sorry. Again, at the angle of 360, it attained as a similar as position of zero. That means there is no flux cut by a conductor, so no EMF. This plotted graph by x and y axis is called a sinusoidal waveform. It consists instantaneous values, as like 0 some instant, A some instant, B some instant. Okay, if you talk about the angular, 0, 45, 90, 180, 270 and 360 and much more if you getting a small slot of time. Okay, so this complete 360 degree rotation, which includes 0 to 180 degree in one direction, 180 to 360 degree in another direction. 0 to 180 degree supports as a positive cycle, and 180 to 360 is supposed to negative. So one positive half cycle and one negative half cycle, one negative half composes a single cycle. It clearly means, एक cycle means जिसमें आधा positive rotation आधा negative rotation, इन दोनों को combine करके हमें जो भी waveform मिलेगा, जो भी graph मिलेगा, हम उसे cycle कहेंगे. या फिर हम another words में बोल सकते हैं कि 0 to 360 degree rotation which plotted graphically called as cycle. Okay, now we will move our discussions towards some technical terms, important terms related with this AC and AC fundamentals, but we will see that in the next lecture. Till then.